good group, and by golly, I'll tell you what, they're in for a good day. Hello again, everybody. Lance Russell and Dave Brown. We're right along ringside, ready to go with another big day of championship wrestling. David.
Oh, I'm ready for this one today. We will be looking at Boy Tony in here. He will not be defending the belt, but he has the belt, the Mid-America Championship. He'll be going in a non-title single match today. A little bit later on, the international champion, Big Bubba. Boy, was he impressive in our first look at him. He'll be back today in a handicap match. Later on, we will have folks such as Tracy Smothers. We will have Gato and Soto will be in a little bit later on, too. And in addition to that, we are going to be bringing back one of the great names out of championship wrestling who will have a special introduction for us. And that comes up very soon.
Yeah, we'll be doing that right after we get back from this opening. So I'll tell you what, in order to get it underway, take time out, and we're going to be back in just 1 minute. Still got plenty of excitement lined up here for you today as we get ready to go with our first match. Before we do, I want to bring in a guy right now that I'll tell you what, his name is absolutely one of those names that you hear every time you start talking wrestling with anybody who's been around more than a couple of weeks, because they all remember, not fondly in some cases, I'm not going to say that charming is the word to say about him, certainly interesting and rough is a way to describe Sputnik Monroe. Let's bring him in here. Yeah, I've had as many people ask about, what about the great Sputnik Monroe? What's happening with him? And we say, well, the last we heard, he's standing right here beside us, Sputnik.
Well, you know me, I've been like Coca-Cola, baby. I've been everywhere.
Everywhere.
So just pick a spot. I had a little tour and wrestled in Africa. But the main reason I'm really here, we're not cutting up jackpots about what I did do or something, but I brought somebody here that can do something, and that's Bubba the Brawler Monroe, born and raised in Memphis, Tennessee. It's time you got set on your ear again.
Oh, this is your son that's going to be involved in the wrestling here
that's
today,
it.
Bubba.
245 pounds of twisted steel sex appeal, Lance Russell.
Okay, Sputnik, we can say this, that if he had a teacher that was any rougher than you are, I can't imagine
doing it. Well, that's why we call him the Brawler.
Yeah. I can imagine to say for a living fact that there's a guy that's got an apt description. The Brawler, Bubba Monroe, and we'll be looking at him. We'll be talking with Sputnik a little bit later on. Dave, we're about ready to go with this opening bout.
In the ring right now for a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. From Memphis, Tennessee, at 216 pounds, over on the right side of the screen, that's Jim Jameson. And going against him, from Alexandria, Louisiana, 242 pounds, Bubba Monroe. One-fall, 10-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun is the referee.
Okay, the bell is off and running, and we're getting our first look at Bubba Monroe Sputnik. I'm going with Jim Jameson, who took that arm and took Bubba over and down right off the bat. We're going to get Sputnik to slide in here and sit down right beside us, and we'll be hearing some comments about his son and his protege. Who?
Lay him in there, Tiger.
Boy, I'll tell you one thing. Ooh, he nailed Jameson hard and then caught him with a forearm in the corner. Beels him back out of that corner and across the ring. Did he come to it naturally, Sputnik? He always wanted to be a wrestler?
Yeah.
What was his attitude about it?
He got kicked out of school a couple of times for fighting, and his mother had always been kind of against me having him work out or anything. But he had a nature like mine, and by looking at him, you can tell that he's exactly like me, and in his attitude and everything else. He's just exactly like his daddy. He's got a, like I told him, you may not want to start this because you got a tough trail to travel. And so.
Cover, one, two, and Jameson kicks out at the two count. Tough trail to cover is right, I'll tell you that, partner.
Well, a lot of juniors have broke into wrestling business, and I think they're probably some of the most famous or infamous are the Fuller brothers and the Fields brothers, and we could go on down the line a long ways, but I don't think they've had the extensive training that he's had, and he was an outstanding athlete in school and lettered in four sports in high school, so
he comes by it naturally, to say the very
least. That's it.
be kind of interesting. I'm sitting here thinking as you're talking about that. We've got a father-son situation, a second-generation wrestling situation right here in our championship wrestling with Jeff Jarrett, the son of Jerry Jarrett, who has just made his debut not too many months ago and has really been very, very impressive as he.
I think you got a, you know, I've always done my homework work real well, and I think you got a Japanese fella named Tanaka, is that true?
Oh, yeah.
His That's father was also a wrestler. Well, you got a lot of second-generation wrestlers. The only difference about that is that I got the best.
Well, that's what we're here to see is Bubba Monroe.
Go ahead and break his arm. If he won't give up, break it.
Hey. No, we don't need to start off his debut with any kind of tactic like that. As he has...
The boy has got to be ignorant if he don't give up with that hole.
He's got his arm really...
You know what
turned
I always
up in that hammerlock.
What I always said, Lance, it takes a fine mind and a fine body and perfect coordination to be a great anything, announcer, wrestler, or whatever. And there it is. The 24-karat gold wrestler right there. Bubba the Brawler Monroe.
Referee telling me better break it up right now as he was a little hard of hearing there at the first, and he comes by that naturally too. In the air, ooh.
PTA.
What is that?
Pain, torture, and agony.
He PTA. Popped him down and nailed it. 1, 2, 3. It was good enough for a pin, too. Bubba Monroe comes through with a victory in there over Jim Jameson, and we'll take a look at that PTA that Sputnik referred to a little bit ago as the finish. He picks him straight up in the air and drives him right down with that spine right down on that knee, and you can see Jameson from then on, it was a question of rolling it up, and right now the referee trying to help Jim out of there.
You got girl wrestlers on TV today?
Well, no, but it's time for us to slide over here to the interview set because the new Mid-America, Sputnik, if you'll just sit right there, we're going to slip right over here. And you are looking at Boy Tony, who kind of stunned the wrestling world when, you got to figure it was an upset. He beat Tracy Smothers and is now the Mid-America heavyweight champ. Take your glory because you're the one that's got the belt.
That's exactly right, Lance Russell. One picture's worth 1,000 words, isn't it? Just take a look, everybody. I am the new champion. And I said I was going to beat Tracy Smothers, and I did just that. And I'm going to continue to be the champion for a long, long time.
Well, we hear the comments from Boy Tony. Now, exactly how long you're going to have that belt will be depend on whether you have to get by, whether you can get by Tracy Smothers. Remember, there's a return clause in that championship. So ultimately, you're going to have to meet Tracy again.
I will be ready when that time comes, Lance Russell. I will be prepared for Tracy Smothers.
Okay, Boy Tony, and we're going to have an opportunity to see him in the ring. We just will go ahead and get it and go with the second match right here in this first set. Before we take, let's just take a break. Let's just go to the ring. And we will be ready to go with our second match of the day. This one is going to be a one-fall, 10-minute time limit bout. And across the way, wrestling out of Memphis, Tennessee, is Mike Murphy. And his opponent in a non-title bout with one fall, 10 minutes in time, at about 235 pounds, wrestling from St. Louis, Missouri, Boy Tony, the Mid-America champion. Your referee for this affair is going to be Jerry Calhoun. I would have to agree with you. He is a little strange in his attire, Sputnik.
The last time I seen a wrestler with a gold purse, it was Cora Combs or somebody. It sure wasn't a guy, so I better bow out of here. I never seen anything like this. I'm not going to comment on it, you know.
I hope you don't on TV. That's the truth. Sputnik Monroe, you've got to believe we'll be seeing a lot more of him before the tour is over with. And look at Tony going after Murphy. Reached out to shake hands with him, kicked him in the midsection. Murphy fell for it, took a thumb from Tony as the referee trying to get in a position to see him. Look at the nice reversal from Mike Murphy. Boy, Tony, again, the referee this time sees him, jumps in and says, watch the thumb. Big upper arm. Well, that's almost too much to take at one time. Sputnik Monroe and Boy Tony back to back.
I tell you, I think you're absolutely right. Sputnik with his son Bubba making an impressive debut here. Had no trouble getting the victory. And Boy Tony, he mentioned in an interview we had with him a week or so ago that he had had a total change. The old Tony Falk, who almost never won a match, had changed. And sure enough, now this guy comes back in here today, and he owns the Mid-America title.
You know, one of the things we said, though, Dave, when Tony Falk was his name, and he was losing match after match, it wasn't that Falk couldn't wrestle, because he could. He just made so many dumb mental errors that he would have a match won, and then he would blow it and end up getting beat.
Time after time, we saw him do that, and that's apparently changed, at least so far.
Mike Murphy trying to battle his way out from under that face lock, which I think had a little eye gouging involved in it.
No, I'm not sure Boy Tony would appreciate it, but I think Boy Tony has put on about 10 pounds, too, since he was here last time.
Yeah.
He's coming in a little heavier than the old 226 that he used to weigh.
Well, it didn't come in his hair because he's lost a little up there on top in one of the more weird hairdos that I've seen on man or woman.
It is a little strange.
Yes. Mike Murphy back into the ropes, and Boy Tony slamming away, whip across the ropes, into the air with a big power slam. Boy, that's something new to Boy Tony's repertoire. We haven't seen that in years gone by. 1, 2, 3, and that's it.
2 minutes, 43 seconds worth of it as Boy Tony takes the victory.
2 minutes. Plus, and Boy Tony is the victor. We've got a little musical look at Boy Tony. Here it is.
Hello, this is Boy Tony, and I want to give you a progress report on how my fan aid campaign has been going. You know, the contributions have been coming in a little slow. I've been doing the best I can with the funds that I have, passing out soap, but it's not good enough, you know. I've got to get you to send your contribution in, and with your help, we can clean up all these dirty wrestling fans in this South. Now, I guess you're wondering what Boy Tony is doing standing here in front of his shower. Well, I realized that it just wasn't good enough just passing out soap, because a lot of people out there don't know how to use it. So today, I'm going to tell you how to use soap, and I'm going to show you. Well, see, it's like this. When you get the soap in your hand, you have to activate the soap. So you need some water. Now, I realize some of you people don't have much running water, but creek water would do just fine. But you got to have some water to activate the soap. So what you want to do is get some water on your skin. So you get under there, and you get it wet, and you take the soap, and you just rub it back and forth. And you see, this white stuff, this is lather. That's it. You lather this soap up, and you just scrub it back and forth real good. And after you get it lathered up real good, you just take it, stick it back under the water, and see how clean and nice that is. Now you do all the parts of your body. I mean, all of them. Just lather it up real good like that. Get under them arms. Just lather it up. Scrub it up real nice. And then take and get that water on it. And see how that is? You can be as clean as Boy Tony. Just be sure to lather that soap up.
Wednesday night, Evansville Coliseum, for the first time. It'll be giveaway night, and look at the prizes you can win.
It's Championship Wrestling Giveaway Night, Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. You'll see great wrestling action with the return of Jerry the King Lawler, plus free prizes for the fans, including 30 quartz digital watches, dolls for the kids, a portable TV, air rifle, AM/FM radio, cassette player, dual cassette recorder, radio headset stereo. All this plus outstanding wrestling action at no increase in prices, Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum.
Great prize night Wednesday night in the Evansville Coliseum, plus an outstanding card with six matches, including a six-man tag match. It'll have Sato, Goto, and Yamamoto against Jarrett, and Wildfire Tommy Rich, with the losing team to be strapped to the top and gets 10 lashes.
That's right, Lance. The loser's going to be strapped to that rope, and this is our kind of match. Tojo, you know we can beat you. All the fans know we can beat you. I can't wait to get to Evansville, because I'm going to strap Tojo till he's going to be bleeding, Lance.
Get there early. You may get one of those prizes too, because there's some dandies to be given away. AWA Southern Heavyweight Championship Act. Here's the man back and ready to go against Dirty Rhodes.
Let me just say this. Dirty Rhodes, I know you're out there. I know you hear what I'm saying. You've had 2 weeks. That's how long I've been suspended for the little bottle incident. Well, you got yourself a 2-week grace period, brother. And during those 2 weeks, I've been sitting and I've been thinking and I've been seething. And I've had all that anger built up inside of me, brother, because nobody's going to do what you tried to do to me and get away with it. If you think me busting that bottle over your head was something, I promise you, Wednesday night, that was just the start of what's in store for you.
Explosion coming up Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum. You got to be out there and see it. And while you're at it, take a look at the great watches and all of that that you may be coming away from the championship wrestling on Wednesday night. This is one night you must be there. Bring in the new international heavyweight champion.
Pardon me.
Let's bring in Big Bubba. He went to battle. This big 407-pounder holds the new international belt.
And right here, Lance Russell. You see this right here? This is what it's all about, the international belt. Lance Russell, I told you, I told all these people last week on this TV here that the next time they'd see me, it'd be with the gold in my hands. The rightful owner of the international belt right here. Well, let me tell you something. I don't care who it is. I'll take on the roughest, the toughest competition that you all have to offer. I don't back down for anybody. I don't plan to be a closet champion. I'm going to have this belt for a long time. It's going to take a big man to take it away from a big man. And names don't mean anybody. That could be anybody that wants this belt. Just come on down. The water's right.
Well, I tell you what, you won't have to go looking for competition. They'll be after that belt. You can bet on it.
I'm ready for him, Lance Russell. And a matter of fact, the pleasure's been all yours because there's some more meat that I have to take care of.
Got a handicap match lined up for Big Bubba today, Dave, and let's go to the ring as we see this giant of a man head up there in a handicap bout today.
Two against one, it's going to be in the handicap match. The Bryant brothers stepping up to ringside right now, Randy and Robert. They weigh in at a total of 474 out of Bartlett, Tennessee. Big Bubba, 6'7", 407. Out of Miami, Florida, current holder of the international belt. Referee Jerry Calhoun, a signal for the bell, and we are underway. The Bryants. Boy, I tell you what, I do not envy the task that these guys have.
This is not the tag format either. Bubba said, yeah, put them both in. Fine with me. They both went down at the same time.
Look at the power of Big Bubba. Randy and Robert. Looking for an opening. Trying for a double leg dive. That didn't work either. Look at that. About a half knee lift, and Randy Bryant went flying halfway across the ring. Bubba grabs Robert now. He's into the rope, ducks under. Big Bubba has him up in the air, lands him. The knee was there. when Bryant got to it.
We've talked about like running into a brick building. Well, there. Oh, look at this. That's all. He didn't even try. He dropped down on him with both legs across, and that is 407 pounds. One, two, three.
Had to be in. Minute 53 seconds of time. A minute 53, and Big Bubba once again incredibly impressive in a handicap match.
Man, I guess so. Hey, I tell you what we better do, too. Maybe we better check that ring. Did you hear that sound
on
the
rope? Yeah, snap. No doubt about it.
Yeah, it sounded like one of them went in there. So right now, we're going to take a look. And a young fella, we get a kick out of looking at him every time we see him in that wrestling ring. We're talking about Jeff Jarrett. Here's a little musical salute with Jeff.
Coliseum Wednesday night, giveaway night. You gotta take a look at this.
It's Championship Wrestling Giveaway Night, Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. You'll see great wrestling action with the return of Jerry the King Lawler, plus free prizes for the fans, including 30 quartz digital watches, dolls for the kids, a portable TV, air rifle, AM/FM radio, cassette player, dual cassette recorder, radio headset stereo. All this plus outstanding wrestling action at no increase in prices. Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum.
Wednesday night, you may be a big winner. By golly, you're going to win all the way with a card that's going to be there. Six outstanding matches, including an AWA Southern Heavyweight Championship match with Jerry Lawler and Dirty Rhodes. A six-man strapping match with Wildfire, Tommy Rich, Jeff, and Jerry Jarrett against Sato, Goto, and Yamamoto. Much, much more.
Just getting tired of that kind of throw. Will you get to the ring up there?
Introduce it.
I'll tell you what, anybody involved with the Jarrett family, anybody that involved with the Jarrett family, I tell you what, I'm going to do a temple to Tessanaka. I don't need TV today. Watch my words.
We're going to get the chair for you, and you can just sit right down in it.
Yeah, the threat by Tojo, he's saying since Patanaka has been a partner with Jeff Jarrett and involved with the Jarrett family, he's going after him today. So watch yourself, Pat. Akio Sato, Tarzan Goto, the ninja with Tojo Yamamoto in air corner. And across the way, it's Tracy Smothers, Pat Tanaka, and David Haskin. That is Akio Sato against Tracy Smothers. Move against Sato, feeling pretty good about it. Crowd liked it too. Tojo over here in the corner, agitating the crowd and Lance and me and everybody else.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, you got to watch your eye because this son of a gun, man, he'll nail you with that stick before you know it. Pat Tanaka hops in the ring with Akio Sato.
Tojo said they're keying on Tanaka in this one. Sato really going after him with a right hand.
Oh, look at here!
Tojo's team, not the only ones that know something about the martial arts out of the Far East. Look at Tanaka. Sato, now Goto. And that headbutt by Goto, devastating. He follows it up with a chop. Smart move by Tanaka. Makes the tag, and here comes David Haskin. Haskins against Goto. Goto again using the head. Haskins again knocked to the mat. Tag by Goto on the ninja. Man under the mask out of the Far East picks up David Haskins.
He's a big ride, dude.
Yeah, he is very tall. Here's Akio Sato back in. He started the match for his team. This time, Haskin gets it down in the small package. Count of one is all he can get. Good move by Haskin. Boy.
Boy, he's getting better and better.
He is. Every time we've seen him recently, he has really looked fine. Seen some good moves. He's reaching for the corner now. Tarzan Goto determined to keep him out of there, and he did keep him away from the tag. Haskins out near the center of the ring. Tarzan Goto jumping up and down on him. Haskins battling back with right hand. The headbutt again by Tarzan Goto puts him to the mat. Haskins staggered with a chop. The ninja back in. Oh, what a kick. Side kick by the ninja. Haskins in desperate need of a tag in the corner, but he's a quarter of the ring away from it right now. Now he's half a ring away as they take him back over to their corner as the tag is made and Akio Sato takes over the action. Tracy Smothers. Smothers starts into the ring after Sato. The referee sends him back out. Tojo poking at him with that stick. You see Tojo right there with a jacket and hat on. Ever present during these matches at ringside. As if Sato and Goto weren't enough, throw in Tojo, and then you throw in the ninja. What a day's work you got.
You know, we know. There's the tag. Here comes Ninja. Sato and Goto, and everybody's in the ring. All six of them at it right now. Tracy Smothers over with Goto, and there goes David Haskins down on the floor.
He was thrown over the top rope. That's disqualification, but the referee did not see it.
I saw that. As Tracy Tojo just laced David Haskins with that kendo stick. Down goes Pat Tanaka. Tojo trying to reach out where he can get him with it. Pokes at him right in the midsection with the end of that stick. Oh, boy, I tell you, you got something coming, Yamamoto. Climbs up into the ring with that stick. That's going to do it, Dave. That'll have to be a disqualification. That doesn't do Pat Tanaka any good as the ninja now has that kendo stick. Tracy tied up in the ropes over there. David Hanson.
Oh! Tanaka ducked and the ninja hit Tojo in the head with a kendo stick, and now Tanaka's got it.
Pat Tanaka ducked out of the way. The ninja nailed Tojo instead. Tanaka gets the kendo stick and he's after him. Yamamoto chugging his little fat frame along. Tanaka beating a tattoo. Gracie's mother's got a lick in. Sato and Goto were smart enough to get out of there.
Yes, indeed. Tracy's mother's had the chair and Tanaka the kendo stick. 5:09 the time on it. Disqualification for the Japanese team. Tracy's mother's Pat Tanaka, David Haskins get the victory.
Boy, I'll tell you, I hate to cheer on somebody using a stick or a chair like that. But, brother, if anybody deserves it, it's Yamamoto, Sato, Goto, and the ninja, too. Situation where Paul Diamond was a victim of these guys, put a chair up in the ring, came off and broke the man's knee. We had some follow-up words we wanted to hear from Paul, and listen to this.
You know, I've been sitting in this room for what it seems like years now, and it's only been a week. I just can't take this anymore, and I have decided to go back home, back to Canada, and I guess see my family. It's been a year and a half since I have seen my family, and I had made big plans to go see them, to have big celebrations, big parties, see all my friends, tell them how well I'm doing, how good everything's going, and instead, I gotta go home on crutches with this darn cast on my leg, and I gotta look my father and my mother right in the eye and say, these three Japanese geeks busted my leg, and here I am, and I need your help. I need some help to be fed, because right now I don't have any money coming in, and I need to survive. I know all the times before you've helped me, but this is one of the toughest ones, because as I said, I want to go home happy and show them how well I'm doing. And instead, here I am on crutches. Tojo, and especially Sato and Goto, I want you to think about that. Think about it real, real carefully, because I'm going to have 8, maybe 10 weeks to think about it. The pain that I'm going to feel going home and looking in my parents' eyes and telling them I'm a loser. Let me tell you something. The longer that it takes, the madder I'm going to get. And when I get in that ring with you, Sato and Goto, you will have enough time to have thought about it too. What it feels like to go home to your country and say, I'm a loser because Paul Diamond took care of me. I'll tell you, brother, I'm going to do anything and everything that I can. And every day I'm going to think about you. And when the time comes, just think about what I said. You one day are going to have to go home, back to Japan, and look at your parents and say, I lost.
Saturday, Ontario, Canada, Paul's home, and he will get his chance. Pat Tanaka,
you pass. I tell you what, Paul Diamond, he's got 6 weeks, okay? So, Japs, you got it in 6 weeks coming, but I got a match signed right now with the ninja. And I'll tell you what, you're going to get it. I'm going to take every ounce that he has, and I'm going to beat him with it.
I don't blame you one bit, Pat, for what they do at any moment, expecting to get poked by Yamamoto. I'm sorry, just a disgrace to your people, Tojo. That's all I got to say. We'll take a break, and we're going to be back in a moment. Incorporated coming in right now. Rick McCord, John. Hall. Boy, do they have a day's work lined up for them. They've got Rhodes and Bass with Larry Wright. Your magnetic personality, That's Dirty Rhodes talking. Well, let's go with the official introduction, Dave.
All right, it'll be one full 10-minute time limit. Introducing, at a total weight of 444 pounds, out of Salem, Virginia, Rick McCord, and out of Minneapolis, Minnesota, John Paul. Together they are Excitement Incorporated, going against them out of Austin, Texas, and Arkansas. Dirty Rhodes and Don Bass in their corner. It's Larry Wright. Bass and Rhodes weigh in at 602 pounds. Starting out, Don Bass against John Paul.
Paul, the larger of the two, Excitement Incorporated wrestlers, McCord, Salem, Virginia, as Dave said, Minneapolis, the home of John Paul.
Don Bass out of Arkansas, big as he is, it takes a good part of that state for him to live in.
Yeah.
Over 300 pounds.
John Paul said a couple of weeks ago when they came in here, we were talking, he said he was delighted to be down here, the home of tag team wrestling. He's going to be even more delighted in about another month or month and a half when that weather turns off in its usual style up in Minneapolis, baby.
You're right. Yeah, he's coming from one of the snow capitals of the world up there.
Dirty Rhodes, John Paul.
Dirty Rhodes and Don Bass, they've had some bad press over their style of wrestling. They have a flagrant disregard for the rules on many, many occasions. But they are big, they are tough, and they can wrestle if they want to.
That's true. Couple of mean dudes, particularly that Dirty Rhodes, boy. You know, it bothers me that they've always got somebody hanging around in the corner. If it's a tag team, they got Larry Wright, the former Torch, in the corner. If it's a single, you'll find if Rhodes is in there, Bass is hanging around. Somebody's always hanging around their corner, meaning no good.
Absolutely. McCord in there now. He's on the mat. Don Bass hanging onto the left arm. He leaves. Dirty Rhodes comes in. They didn't bother to tag.
Oh, got him over.
McCord, yeah. Good move. You got to be careful with that, though. You can break your own arm.
And you got 300 pounds on the other end of it.
That's right.
Good straight right hand that Dirty Rhodes threw, but boy, McCord was long gone by the time it got to him.
Dirty Rhodes out of the corner. We got Don Bass holding McCord up. He moves out of the way just in time, and Dirty Rhodes runs into Don Bass's partner. Bass knocked down off the ring apron. Doesn't appear to be seriously shaken up. He's back up there now. McCord makes the tag on John Paul. Rhodes gets the tag on Don Bass, holds John Paul up while Don Bass let him have it with a right hand. Into the turnbuckle. John Paul really being worked on here by Don Bass.
Big knee lift. Don Bass going after John Paul.
3.5 minutes gone in the match. Tag made by Don Bass now. You know, at least one advantage. Hey, there's a tag by John Paul. Rick McCord coming in. He's going against both Don Bass and Dirty Rhodes.
Well, we got them all four. I hope maybe the fifth one stays out of there.
McCord slamming Don Bass down to the mat. He's up on the middle rope. Look out, Larry Wright from outside trips him up. McCord hits the mat. Don Bass turns him over, covers. Count as one, two. It's going to be it. Three.
Well, there it is, the situation.
The third man in the corner is the one who causes the problem for Rick McCord.
Dirty Rhodes has got the chair in his hand. He is over here threatening John Paul with a chair. So the referee has got, you can see him, is over there. Look at Larry Rice. Grabbed him right by the ankle, picked him off the rope.
Referee has just reversed the decision. He gave it to John Paul, and Rick McCord due to outside interference.
One of those rare occasions where the referee consulted with the people or somebody, found out about Torch Larry Wright being involved. And there's Dirty Rhodes ripping him with that chain right across his knuckles while Larry Wright holds him. And McCord being bounced around hard while John Paul has his head slammed into a turnbuckle by Don Bass. Referee trying to pull them up apart. Ah, here comes some guys. Good. Rick McCord bleeding. Profusely. Rhodes has got that chain in his hand that he used to bust Rick McCord open with. So the winners officially are Excitement Incorporated.
That is KYB, baby, kicking your booty.
Yeah, and you had to use a chain to do it. You end up losing the match to boot. Excitement Incorporated, the winners, John Paul and Rick McCord. And what was the time, Dave?
4:07.
4:07, the official time in that match. We're going to take time out. We're going to be back with more action coming up with the Memphis Ice Vice scheduled to go against Jerry Lawler and William the Freezer Thompson. They need to get Rick back out of here. We'll be back in just a moment.
Wednesday night, Evansville Coliseum, son of a gun, I have said it. Giveaway night for the first time in history, and you'll want to be a part of it, particularly when you see the prizes that are going to be in store for you. Take a look.
It's Championship Wrestling Giveaway Night, Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum. You'll see great wrestling action with the return of Jerry the King Lawler, plus free prizes for the fans, including 30 quartz digital watches, dolls for the kids, a portable TV, air rifle, AM/FM radio, cassette player, dual cassette recorder, radio headset stereo. All this plus outstanding wrestling action at no increase in prices. Wednesday night at the Evansville Coliseum.
The great giveaway night, Wednesday night, Evansville Coliseum, plus an AWA Southern Heavyweight Championship match. It'll have Jerry Lawler going against Dirty Rhodes.
Let me tell you something, Lance Russell. When that Jerry Lawler got that Tommy Rich, brother, we told you we was going to kill him and send him out of town, and that's what happened. And these people saw here just a week or so ago, brother, I put both these size 14s on that big old crown that belongs to that king, and he's no longer a king. Now, right there in Evansville, Wednesday night, Jerry Lawler, I'm going to take that Southern belt from you, brother, and then you can just get out of town because that's what you love most of all, and I'm going to take it.
Well, we'll be finding that one out. Easier said sometimes than doing. Hey, how about the final match up there that's going to be a six-man tag match with Yamamoto, Sato, and Goto going against Jarrett, and Wildfire Tommy Rich, and the losing team gets tied up to the top rope in 10 legs.
We're not the losing team. Tommy Rich, you join the Jarrett, the loser team, the coward, rotten dog team. We're going to beat you, my two Imperial boys. You're not going to lose. We're going to tie you two, three up, and we're going to each going to get 10 laps, 10, 20, 30 laps. You understand?
Yeah, we hear what you're saying. It's going to be a whale of a night of action out there Wednesday night. One of those nights you must be there.
Another name from the past that's be coming back, Dennis Hall. Here's an interview. I haven't had a chance to see it yet either, so let's take a listen to it.
Hey, Lance, old buddy, good to talk to you again. Haven't talked to you in a number of years. I guess I better introduce myself. Folks out there might not recognize me or even remember me. My name's Dennis Hall. I wrestled in this area several years ago, quite prominent in the area. Last few years, been on the West Coast, doing quite well out there. They got some great talent out there, nothing like Tennessee or the Midwest here. Took a little time off, seen two or three movies out there. You might have saw it down at the theater. They showed it downtown here. Was in Las Vegas, wrestling in Las Vegas. And at this point, I've got some good and I got some bad news. Now, the bad news is I'm no longer available. Now, the good news is I'd like for you folks to meet a little lady I met in Las Vegas, Miss Dolly Parker. Ain't she something? Look at this hair. Ain't she something? Now, I know you're saying, how did they meet? How did they get together? Well, I guess I better tell you. I'd like to tell you.
Din, let me tell these people how we got together. I went to a wrestling match in Las Vegas after working one night, and I seen Din up there, and I knew when I saw him that he was the man for me.
Hey, I like to tell you folks, you probably don't know that this little lady about the talent she's got. Do you think Dolly Parton can sing? You ought to see this little lady here. This little lady sings. She sings, dances, acts, been in a couple movies. Probably seen them downtown here.
And I didn't mind giving up my career to be behind Din.
That's right, folks, and she'll stick with beside me or behind me or wherever we need to, wherever she needs to be stuck to be with me at any given time. Now, I'd just like to say this here. I realize you've got the top talent in the country here, and that's why we're here. And that's why she says, hey, we're going to Nashville, Din. We're going to Nashville because that's where it's at. That's where it's happening out there. But her career, I said, honey, you can't give up that good career out here in Las Vegas.
But Din knows I didn't mind giving up my career to be with him. It's me and Din all the way to the top.
And I know you folks are, you just can't wait to see us and meet us and see us in person. I'll tell you what, we're going to be appearing in this area, and we're looking forward to meeting all you folks. So y'all come out and see us. Miss Dolly, hey, give me a little kiss, Miss Dolly. Oh, that's what gets me going. That's where I get my drive, folks. And we'll see you out there.
Coming up right now, tag team action. Tracy Smothers stepping into the ring with William the Freezer Thompson. And going against him, the Memphis Vice. All right, Memphis Vice, 100% tough, it says on Jerry Bryant's shirt. Mr. Everything, it says on the back of the tights of Lou Winston.
Always look forward to seeing the Memphis Vice, if for nothing else, just to read their walking billboards. They always got plenty of messages. Jerry has on the back of his tights, Cool Breeze. Bell time, and we're ready to go. The Freezer starting out against Big Lou.
Freezer is huge. It's the only word to describe him. Lou Winston.
Big Lou goes about 250, but he's dwarfed by the Freezer, isn't he?
He sure is. Boy, the Freezer weighs in way up around that 300 range. Jerry Bryant jumps in the air, and Freezer just sends him flying. Tracy Smothers steps in. A little celebration between Tracy and Mr. Thompson. Jerry Bryant and Lou Winston, boy, they complained to the referee. Did you see what he did? He had to be pulling tights and pulling hair and anything else illegal I can think of to complain about. That's what Bryant was saying.
Or anything that I can think of to complain about. He does run that mouth.
Oh, he does.
Top wrist lock. Jerry Bryant run back in the corner, and the Freezer just tossed him out of there. Tracy Smothers filling in for the King. We did confirm that he was stuck in Minneapolis on his way back from Hawaii and unable to be here in time for the match. So Tracy steps back in here. Big Lou and William Thompson meeting. Mr. Everything puts a tag on Cool Breeze.
Cool Breeze, Jerry Bryant. He's going with a standing wrist lock, and that's not a very wise choice of holds for his situation with a man taller and heavier than he is. That'll make it work.
I figured he'd do something.
Yeah, yank his hair. That'll do it. Jerry Bryant.
Bottom a minute to go in the expiration of time, and we're going to have to call it quits in this match between the Memphis Vice and William Thompson. Tracy Smothers, Bryant hanging onto the arm bar of Thompson down on the deck. As it stands now, it doesn't look like we'll have a decision out of this one, Dave, as the time is running out.
Get down there very close. Bryant has the freezer on the mat, but he's not in any position to go for a cover at this point.
No, you're right. I don't think there's any way he could get him in. He'll aggravate him, though. You can bet on that.
Memphis Vice makes a tag. Lou Winston, boot to the midsection. Big right hand puts him down.
30 seconds to go in our expiration of time.
The freezer makes another shot for Lou Winston.
Our time.